All right, so should we get started?
Yeah.
Okay, so this being a lightning talk, I have skipped the demo, and I'm going to cover the ideas where how the SQL is going to be applicable with Apache Apex. So Apex is a streaming engine, and SQL has been traditionally known for something like a RDBMS systems where the data is already residing. Okay, but when you talk about streaming engine, the data is continuously flowing. Okay, so how do you make use of that? So that's what we're going to cover today. So the very first question is, why did we go ahead with SQL? Okay, and these are the, you know, you can see years since 1996. It has been popularly used even till now. Okay, why? Because that has been a traditional expertise that is present with everyone. Okay, it's like nowadays SQL is taught in the engineering college days as well. Okay, so it's that much popular that people who are having SQL expertise, they don't want those particular enterprises don't want to go out and find out people who don't have the SQL expertise or have something about streaming technology and they can build application for them. Okay, all the enterprises want to do is that if somebody has a SQL expertise, use their expertise to do the same thing maybe in a different platform. Okay, so that's where we thought that, you know, SQL still is a popular choice and we have to, you know, give support for SQL to be used in streaming as well for Apache Apex. So basically, to do that, what we used a project, something called as Apache Calcite. Okay, so that's also open source project. So Apache Calcite is also open source project. What it does, it provides you a layer where it separates out the SQL parsing, SQL validations, SQL optimizations, and even execution side. Okay, so all these layers that you see, a particular JDBC server, that might be MySQL, that might be Oracle DB or anything, it has these, you know, generic layers which are existing. Okay, so at the top is a JDBC server layer where it's a communication layer which communicates with client. Then you have a parser and validator which is going to parse the queries and do the validations on it. Okay, at this particular point of time, it converts the query into something called as relational expression. Okay, so relational algebra is a popular representation that every other RDBMS is using to represent a SQL statement to something that is executable. Okay, so SQL validator and parser, after that stage is where the a particular SQL statement is converted to relational algebra. The query optimizer then optimizes that particular relational algebra to even more optimistic way, so that for the execution is much more efficient. Okay, and finally it comes down to the third party plugin stages where whether it should go to what type of store can be decided. Okay, now what Calcite did is it provided all these layers individually. Okay, and that is where it allows you to tap at any particular place, and I can say that I just want to use from JDBC server to the query optimizer and I have my own store. Okay, so that is where it says that I can plug in my third party ops. Okay, that is where something like a MongoDB, which is a NoSQL database, it just gives queues to the SQL parsers and optimizers that I am working with NoSQL database, I don't have RDBMS system, but if you give me a relational expression, I can execute it on my own. Okay, so what MongoDB does is it just puts a third party op saying that how to execute a SQL statement on the MongoDB, or it can be edge based or anything for that matter. Okay, this is the beauty of Calcite. So Calcite has separated out all the different layers in the JDBMS architecture. Okay, and we are going to use basically this particular concept to use a SQL statement for execution of a DAG. Okay, so what we do is we use the layer of SQL parser and optimizer. Okay, so we say that we will provide you input, just skip the JDBC server, we'll provide the input to the parser, we'll take the output from query optimizer itself. Okay, at this point of time, I get an optimized relational algebra, okay, which I can convert that to a DAG. Okay, so this is a basic relational expression tree or relational algebra, how it looks like. So let's say you have a select statement, something as complex as this. So this has a join statement, it has a where clause, it has group by statements, it has order by. Okay, so basically what I'm trying to convey here is that it is not just stateless. Okay, so something like a scalar operation on a particular column can be a scalar, can be a stateless operation, but when you try to do join, it has to be stateful. When you try to do a group by, it has to be stateful. Order by is again stateful. So this particular statement actually gets converted into two different, this particular expression tree. And this is all Calcite, how Calcite does it. Okay, so you can see that there's a table called as Splunk, which is coming from Splunk. Now, the other table is actually coming from MySQL. So you can see that the two tables on which the join is happening, on that one is coming from Splunk and another is coming from MySQL. Why is that possible? Because Calcite allows you to put plugins. If you can go to previous slide, Calcite allows you to put various different plugins here. Okay, at that layer. Okay, so I can say that my one table corresponding from Splunk, other is coming from any specific RDM members. Okay.
Where? So can you just come again?
So
where is my plugin? Where are you plugging in your?
I'll come to that. I'm just explaining how Calcite really works with the relational algebra. Typically, you would have a table in a single storage system, right?
Correct.
Only Oracle or only MySQL. Okay. Why we could have one table coming from Splunk and another table coming from MySQL is because Calcite has separated out all the different layers of our JD Maven system. Okay. So that is where a pluggable model can fall. And I can say that no one table corresponds to a Splunk, another corresponds to MySQL. Okay. We will come to how Apex is done. So this is how basically the relational tree gets created from the SQL statement. Okay, it takes the data, it scans. So scan is an operator, it's a relational operator. It scans the data, it joins them, it filters for the where condition. Then there's a group relational operator for the group by clause, and then finally is a sort, which is for the order by. Now there's a problem in this, okay? Can go to the next slide. So the problem that is observed, and this is something which is part of optimization, is if you see the where clause is always on the Splunk table. It doesn't correspond to MySQL table, okay? So why should I have the filter after join? I can have the filter before join, and that way the number of rows that are coming into join are reduced. My DAG or the relational algebra automatically get optimized. This is one of the very, very simple rules. There are, I think, somewhere around 1500 rules which gets applied on specific SQL statement. And Apache Calcite has all of them. Moreover, one can actually put custom SQL, the custom of these optimization rules so that you can tune your own relational tree accordingly. Now, this is how the Calcite looks
it's
like.
Cost-based.
It's cost-based.
Not rule-based.
There are rule-based and cost-based also, but cost is by default. Now, this is how the relational algebra looks like from a Calcite's perspective. But the peculiarity here, as compared to Apex, is it looks something like DAG. Now, if I can replace these individual stages with operators, my work was done, right? If this is the output of Calcite, I can take these, I can replace that join stage with the join operator, and my work can be done. Okay, and that is how we leverage the Calcite to do a SQL interfacing. Can you go this? So this is what happens actually. You have a select statement where you are reading the data from Kafka. Again, it's an abstraction, right? We just saw Splunk, we just saw MySQL. It can be abstracted out. So we can have a table which is an abstraction coming from Kafka. Okay. And we are just putting some filter condition, we are doing some scalar operation on floor, on row time. And finally dumping the data down to a file system. So this is how the select statement would look like. When you say from Kafka, that becomes a source. When you say insert into file, that becomes a destination. So a standard ETL pipeline can be built something like this. This gets converted using the Calcite planner. There's a process called as Calcite planner. It's a library basically. It's an API which is called as Calcite planner, which converts this particular select statement into optimized relational algebra. And then finally we take that and replace into a DAG. The only thing that we take care of is scan operator. We figure out that it corresponds, the scan corresponds to Kafka, and we still have to work with the row type data. So we put Kafka input operator and a parser next to that. What gets emitted from a parser is something that goes to the input filter. Okay. So that's a one-to-one mapping you can see. Even at the output side, at the insert, it's a file-based insert. Okay. So I need to somehow do the formatting of the row types that I'm getting. So we have a format operator there. So this all is automatically identified by Apex. And using Apache Calcite's relational algebra, we make sure that a SQL statement gets equivalently converted to a DAG. Okay? And this is currently in a very much running state. We have a join support also. We have something coming up for streaming aggregates. Okay? So streaming aggregate concept is based on the fact that, is everyone aware of event time windowing here? So event time windowing is a concept in streaming where it says that your data is coming out of order, okay? And you need to either order it and process, or you need to, without ordering, you need to correlate and process. Okay? Okay. So the second part is what event time, window time comes. And previous session by Beam, it exactly does that. It is completely based on event time window. So streaming aggregates is something similar to that. So the data is flowing, but it is completely messed up. It's completely out of order. How do you order it and still do a group by, still do a order by? Okay. That is streaming aggregates or streaming sort. Okay. So all these works are, all these things are work in progress. The streaming join is done. So we can actually do a join as a join of the two streams. Okay. So the previous expression, this what we saw, this can be done right now. Okay. So that's all I have. We recently had a webcast on this. The video of that is present on YouTube, and there are a bunch of other documentation also which are available. So you can actually go to that YouTube link. So there's a youtube.com/user/datatorrent. So you can see a webcast video there, and that actually shows a demo of how SQL can be used. Okay. We are also coming up with an CLI, SQL CLI, where you can just type the table that you register, okay, all that you can do is like create table and define a table, and that gets abstracted out, okay, or delete tables, and then run finally the insert statement, and that finally kicks in as a tag. So basically execution from a CLI. So one need not really work at all with Java. One can just work with select statement and still work with Apex. So right now it is a little bit of Java flavor is there. Any questions? No.